स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ क्वालिटी, चैप्टर नंबर 5 ऑफ योर बुक. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट आर चैप्टर. कैन अ शू मेकर बी कॉल्ड एन आर्टिस्ट? द राइटर इज आस्किंग यू अ क्वेश्चन. कैन यू कॉल अ शू मेकर एन आर्टिस्ट? यस, इफ ही हैज़ द सेम स्किल एंड प्राइड इन हिज ट्रेड एज एनी अदर आर्टिस्ट. इफ द शू मेकर has a pride and skill for his trade as any other artist, then we can call him a artist and the same respect for it too, and he has the same respect for his trade. Mr. Gessler, a German shoemaker settled in London, is a perfect artist. Mr. Gessler, who is a German but now he was settled in London, is a perfect artist. Read this story to see how he devotes his life to his art. Now we will read this story and we will find out how he devotes his life to his art. I knew him from the days of my extreme youth because he made my father's boot. In this chapter, I is the narrator. And the narrator knew Mr. Gessler. Him is Mr. Gessler when he was quite young. The reason was that he made the shoes for his father. He lived with his elder brother in his shop, which was in a small by street in a fashionable part of London. And he lived with his elder brother in a small shop, which was near a fashionable part of London. The shop had a certain quite distinction. It means the shop was quite different from the other shops. There was no sign upon it other than the name of Gessler brother. There was no signboard, only the name of Gessler brothers. And in the window a few pairs of boots. And there are only a few pairs of boots in the window. He made only what was ordered. They made shoes or boots on order. And what he made never failed to fit. And whatever he made, the fitting was excellent. To make boots, such boots as he made, seems to me then and still seems to me mysterious and wonderful. To the narrator, it seems mysterious and wonderful to make such kind of boots as they made. I remember well my shy remarks one day while stretching out of him my youthful foot. Isn't it awfully hard to do, Mr. Gessler? When the narrator was young, he said to Mr. Gessler that it was a very difficult task. And his answer, given with a sudden smile from out of the redness of his beard, "It is an art. It is an art." It means he was a German and he was speaking in a German tone. It means it is an art. And Mr. Gessler answered with his smiling face that making shoes was an art. It was not possible to go to him very often. His boots lasted terribly, having something. Now the narrator is saying he went to his shop rarely because his boots lasted terribly. Lasted terribly means they lasted very long time. Having something beyond the temporary, some essence of boot stitched into them. The narrator was saying that they have some special kind of thing so that they lasted for a long time. One went in, not as into most shops, but restfully as one enters a church and sitting on the single wooden chair, waited. Now the narrator is comparing the shop to a church. There nobody went like a normal shop, but enter as somebody is entering a church. A guttural sound and the tip-tap of his slippers beating the narrow wooden stairs, and he would stand before one without coat, a little band in the leather apron with sleeves turned back, blinking as if awakened from some dream of boots. In this paragraph, the narrator is describing Mr. Gessler when a customer waited for him. A guttural sound. Guttural sound means a harsh sound of tip-top of his slippers, because Mr. Gessler coming down from the stair, wooden stair, and the customer can easily hear the sound of his slippers. He would stand before one without coat, a little band in leather apron with sleeves turned back, blinking as if awakened from some dream of boots. And he did not wear coat. He bent before the customer in his leather apron, and his sleeves were folded backward, and he blinked his eyes as he awakened from some dream of boots. And I would say, how do you do, Mr. Gessler? Could you make me a pair of Russian leather boots? And the narrator asks Mr. Gessler, how do you do, and ask him to make him a pair of Russian leather boots. Without a word, he would leave me, retiring whence he came or into the other portion of the shop. And Mr. Gessler, without answer, left the narrator to wait and went to the other portion of the shop, or there from he came. And I would continue to rest in the wooden chair, inhaling the incense of his trade. And the narrator waited in the wooden chair and inhaled to breathe in the incense, the smell of leather of his trade. Soon he would come back, holding in his hand a piece of gold-brown leather. And after some time, Mr. Gessler came back with a piece of brown leather holding in his hand. With eyes fixed on it, he would remark, and to see that leather, he remarked, what a beautiful bead. Bead means piece. It is a beautiful piece of leather. When I too had admired it, he would speak again. When the narrator is also praised that piece, he continued to speak, when do you want them? And I would answer. He said, when he want them? And the narrator answered, oh, as soon as you conveniently can, as soon as possible. And he would say, tomorrow fortnight. And he answered, tomorrow fortnight. For if he were his elder brother, I will ask my brother. And he answered, when his elder brother will come, he will ask his elder brother. Then I would murmur, I, the narrator, murmur to speak very slowly. Then the narrator say very slowly, thank you. Thank Mr. Gessler. Good morning, Mr. Gessler. Good morning. He would reply, still looking at the leather in his hand. But Mr. Gessler still looking at the leather and reply to the narrator, good morning. And as I moved to the door, I would hear the tip-tap of his slippers going up the stairs to his dream of boots. When the narrator left the shop, he heard the tip-tap of his slippers. As he was going upstairs to his dream of boots, I cannot forget that day on which I had occasion to say to him, "Mr. Gessler, that last pair of boots creak, you know." In this paragraph, the narrator is describing an incident in which he said, "Mr. Gessler, that last pair of boots was creaked." He looked at me for a time without reply. Mr. Gessler looked at the narrator without any reply, as if he expecting me to withdraw or qualify the statement. As Mr. Gessler was expecting the narrator to take back his statement, then said, "It shouldn't have cracked." "It did, I am afraid," Mr. Gessler said. "It should not have creaked." But the narrator said, "It did. You got them wet before they found themselves." Mr. Gessler said in his German English that he got them wet before they found themselves. It means you have wet the shoes. "I don't think so," but the narrator refused. At that, he lowered his eyes as if hunting for memory of those boots, and I felt sorry I had mentioned this grave thing. "Send them back," he said. "I will look at them." In this line, narrator is saying that Mr. Gessler lowered his eyes as the memory of the shoes haunting him. Haunting means he was afraid by the memory of those shoes, and the narrator felt sorry that he mentioned about those shoes. Then Mr. Gessler said, "Send them back." "Send them back" means send them back. "I will look at them." He said to the narrator to send those shoes back, and he would look at them.